Hello students of class 5, this is your Bridget ma'am to teach you lesson 2, The Land of the Little People by Jonathan Swift. The Lilliputians symbolize humankind's wildly excessive pride in its own small existence. In the lesson, they call Gulliver the Great Man Mountain. During his first voyage, Gulliver is washed ashore after a shipwreck and finds himself a prisoner of a race of tiny people less than 6 inches. They are physically and morally smaller than Gulliver. They are dangerous and cruel in spite of their small size. Now I will read to you the lesson. Open your readers to chapter 2 and follow the reading. Lemuel Gulliver is an Irish surgeon and sailor. During one of his voyages, there is a great storm and the ship on which he sails sinks. He manages to swim to land. Gulliver was tired and lay down on the soft grass near the shore. He slept soundly for many hours. When he woke up, it was daylight. He tried to get up, but could not. His legs, arms, and hair were tied to the ground, and he could not move his body or turn his head. He was afraid. Then a strange thing happened. Gulliver felt something moving, first along his left leg and then on his chest. Looking down, he saw a little man, not more than 6 inches tall, with a bow and arrows in his hand. About 50 other little men followed him, all carrying bows and arrows. Gulliver was astounded. He shouted loudly and pulled his arm from the ground, breaking the cords which tied them down. Then he tried to get up, ripping the cords that held down his legs and hair. This frightened the little men, and they ran away. But they soon returned and started shooting arrows at Gulliver from a distance. The arrows pricked Gulliver like needles. Gulliver acted wisely. He did not try to catch any of the little men. Instead, he made a sign to them and they stopped shooting arrows at him. Then he brought the fingers of his right hand to his mouth to show that he wanted food. The little men understood and soon brought several baskets of food and 2 barrels of wine. The food consisted of legs of mutton and loaves of bread. The men put their longest ladders against Gulliver's sides and carried the basket of food to his mouth. Gulliver chewed and swallowed 2 or 3 legs of mutton and 3 of the tiny loaves at a time. After he had emptied the baskets, the little men rolled the barrels of wine over his chin and opened the tops. He emptied each barrel in one gulp and wanted more, but they had no more to give him. Gulliver felt better now. The king and queen of these little people lived in the capital, about 1/2 mile from where Gulliver was. The king ordered his men to bring the man mountain to him. It was not an easy thing to do, but the little men were very clever. They made a long carriage which was 3 inches high and had 22 wheels. 900 of the strongest men among them rolled Gulliver onto it and fastened him safely. 1,500 of the king's finest horses pulled the carriage along the road. The next day, Gulliver was brought to the capital. They untied his hands and legs and allowed him to stand up, because now they knew that he did not intend to harm them. But they changed his left foot to the carriage with 90 tiny chains to prevent him from escaping. The king, the queen, and thousands of little men, women, and children came to see the Man Mountain. Most of these people were friendly to Gulliver, but some of them were hostile and started shooting arrows at him. Gulliver stretched out his hand and caught 6 of the men. He put 5 of them into his pocket and pretended to eat the 6th one. The men started crying and Gulliver let them go. Gulliver lived happily on this island for many months. The king appointed 300 cooks to prepare his food and 300 tailors to make a new suit for him. 6 of the wisest men taught him the language of the island. From them he learned that the little country was called Lilliput. Now children, take out your pencil and underline the difficult words. Gulliver, frightened, needles, understood, mutton, loaves, ladders, carriage, Lilliput, emptied. Now, learn the spellings and make sentences of your own. Learn the other new words given at the bottom of your page. Comprehension answers, complete the sentences I have typed for you. Take them down in your copies and learn them. Come to the grammar, please. Be on page 14 and understand as I explain. Look at these sentences. Gulliver was a sailor. The men were afraid of Gulliver. We know that in a sentence, the noun or pronoun that does the action is called the subject, and the action itself is called the verb. The main verb in a sentence must always agree with its subject in number and person. Now these two topics you will do more thoroughly from your grammar books, but to speak English well, you need these three: the first, second, and third person in this chart. How it is used, you must learn them, memorize them, so that you can make sentences while speaking correctly. There are sentences. Please come to the complete the sentences. You have also the answers that are there typed for you. Please take them down, but before taking them down, you please read the sentences. Coming down to your vocabulary, read the sentences. Gulliver pulled his arms up from the ground, breaking the cords which tied them down. The little people trusted Gulliver because he never broke the laws of their land. Now in both the sentences, the two different forms of the verb break mean two different things. In sentence 1, it means to split or shatter into pieces. In sentence 2, it is part of a fixed expression. It has a special meaning and conveys something different from the meaning of the words break and law. Since the law cannot be broken into pieces, the expression means do not follow a set of laws. Now you have the match the expressions with break in column A to their meaning in column B. Answers, match the answers correctly by reading and then matching. Any doubt, you can look up for the answers that are typed. Exercise B, vocabulary. Answers are typed. Read the sentences, then fill up the blanks. I have stressed on reading the sentences because you never know when and where you have to use them in future. Your writing section, read the paragraphs. We have learned about a paragraph and how to write one. A topic sentence is the most important sentence in a paragraph and it conveys the whole idea of the paragraph. It is usually the first sentence in a paragraph. Reading the paragraph given in your book, Gulliver lived happily on the island of Lilliput for many months. The king appointed 300 cooks to prepare his food and 300 tailors to make a new suit for him. 6 of the wisest men taught him the language of the land. The little people trusted Gulliver because he did not break the laws. Gulliver was very happy. The sentence Gulliver lived happily on the island of Lilliput for many months is the topic sentence of the paragraph above. It gives us an idea of what the rest of the paragraph is about. Read this paragraph, the A section, read this paragraph, identify the topic. Read it, write the whole paragraph in good handwriting. The topic sentence of this, of the B section, now come to the right topic sentences of paragraph B. You have two paragraphs of B section, 1 and 2. The topic sentence, I have written them down for you. First one is healthy body, that is typed. And second one is good handwriting. You have the punctuation. Read these sentences with full stops, question marks, capital letters, exclamation mark and possessive apostrophes in the correct places. By possessive apostrophes, it means things that belong to you. Now, I'm very sure every exercise of this topic is done by you earlier. It is easy. Please do it correctly and write them down in your copies. Please, children, write the section, write the paragraphs in your copy as good handwriting practice. Remember to begin the sentence with a capital letter. Most important for you, please don't shirk work. Do not do all your exercises. Practice reading and practice handwriting. Learn all what is said to be learned. Your question and answers, your new words, making of sentences, and write a few, the last one, writing, you just write a few lines about the story that you have understood, all about this Gulliver. Take care and be happy. Remember, you will be marked in all your assignments. First do your studies and then you can play. Thank you.